Hey, what's going on? This is Sarah Lee Day, and you're watching another episode of Dubsado Tidbits, the things you need to know about Dubsado delivered in bite-sized pieces. Earlier this week, we started talking about the utility section of Dubsado, and today we're going to finish that off by talking about the time tracker. So let's take a look. Over here on the left, you're going to click on Utilities drop-down, and then Time Tracker. Now, the time tracker is used for any projects that you need to actually track your time, because you're charging an hourly rate for that project. And you can do that directly in Dubsado instead of having to use a third-party app. So when you come in here, the first thing you're going to see is any open times that you have already logged that have not been applied to any invoices. Then you can also click here to see the invoice. These are going to be the times that you've actually applied to an invoice and sent to a customer. And then you can also see all, which is just a combination of the two, any open ones, any invoice ones, all of the times that you've logged in Dubsado. So under open, if you're wanting to start a new time, you would put in what you're working on. So let's just say this is account setup project. You're going to click here and you'll be able to select any of the projects that you have available. Right now, we just have our one sample client project, so I'm going to select that. Then, once you do, you can change that if you need to, if you needed to select a different project, maybe you picked the wrong one. And you have the option here of creating a new invoice for that project when you start logging your time. Now, if you don't want to do that, you would simply click the X here, and that will prevent this new time from actually creating an invoice in that project. The difference is going to be if you already have an invoice on the project, you don't want to create a new one, or if maybe you are just wanting to track your time for internal purposes and you're not actually going to put that information on the invoice, you might see deselect that there. But for this training, let's go ahead and create a new invoice just to see what that looks like in the project when we do track some time. Next, you're going to fill in your hourly rate, and you can put a description here if you'd like. So let's just say hourly rate for account setup. We're going to put in, let's just say a rate of 40. If this is taxable, you'll select your tax rate here. And then you'll select whatever category you need for your chart of accounts tracking. I'm going to put that under basic setup. And after all of that's ready, then you'll click this green arrow to start the timer. And you'll see that it creates a new line item here. It's got the item name, which is what we typed here as far as like what we're doing. Description, that is the notes that we put in when we were filling in the rate. Under project, this is the project that we are applying this to, our sample job name, sample project. You can see here that we can also apply this to the invoice. So after we have logged our time, after we've stopped our time, if we did actually want to put that on the invoice, directly on the invoice for the client, we could do that here by clicking Apply to Invoice. Date is the day that you're tracking. Tax, if we had that tax selected when we were doing our rate up here, it would show here. This is the user. So if you have multiple team members who are doing work for clients, you can see who actually tracked the time, their hourly rate. Right now, this is showing in progress because our clock is running. And total, so these two are going to update as soon as we hit stop on our tracker. Now, you also notice over here on the left that we have this red dot that is kind of pulsing. And no matter where you are in your account, you can be under dashboard, under projects, no matter where you navigate to in your account, you'll be able to see that you are still logging time, and that time is still tracking here. And to go back to it, it's actually not under tasks. To go back to it, you would just come back down here to time tracker. And as soon as you're done tracking your time and you're ready to kind of stop that timer, you'll come back and hit the stop. And now you'll see that the time has updated to the exact amount of time that you were running the tracker. And your total has calculated based on your hourly rate here. So that takes out the manual step of having to figure out, well, I worked this many hours and this many minutes and this many seconds. What does that translate to as far as my hourly rate? You don't have to round anything. It's going to calculate that for you. And then when you're ready to put that on the invoice, you can just apply it to invoice here. Let's just do that. And now it's no longer under open, it's under invoiced. And that has put that time and that dollar amount directly on an invoice in the project, which we'll go take a look at here in just a second. The other thing that you can do for your times here in this section is under the actions log, you can copy this time if you want to duplicate it, or you can delete this time here. Now, over here under the open, if we had not applied that time directly to the invoice, let's actually just do another time here for workflow strategy project. We'll do it under the same project. This one, I am not going to create a new invoice because we already have an invoice. I'm going to put the rate here, category here. We'll just say workflow strategy, and let's start. Okay, now over here in the actions column, we can't do these yet, but the actions that are available are to play. So that is adding more time onto your current time. You can edit. So if you maybe forgot to turn the tracker off and it ran for a couple extra minutes, you can edit that time. Or you can delete the tracker if something happens and the tracker was running, it shouldn't be, or whatever. You can always delete that time. So let's go ahead and stop this one and take a look at what these do. So again, when you hit the play button, right now we're at 35 seconds on this project. If you hit play, it's going to pick right back up where you left off, and it's going to keep adding time to that same time log. Now, if we stop this, and let's say we actually did 1 minute 57 seconds and we had forgotten to turn the tracker on. So we could come here and click edit, and we can add an extra minute here and click the check mark. Now, if you're editing it, it's not going to allow you to edit the seconds. So that part did actually change. This was 57 seconds. And what it did was it rounded it up to the nearest minute. So when we edited that, it did change that total time here. So keep that in mind if you need to edit. Now, again, if we didn't need this time, if it was an accident or just something we were messing around with, we could also delete it here. And yes, delete. Now it's gone. All right, so let's go take a look really quickly at the invoice time that we created for this sample project. Over here in invoices, I know we haven't really talked about the projects area yet this far into the project, so don't be confused by that. I'm just kind of showing you what it looks like on the invoice. So here in the invoices for this project, you can see we have our item, the account setup, our description here. This is what we put in when we're setting that up. It's got the category, it has the quantity. The quantity is basically the time that we spent, how much time we spent. There's no discount, no tax, and our hourly rate here, then the subtotal here of our quantity or our time multiplied by our hourly rate. And then that's totaled down here. And that's it for today's tidbit. For more information about receiving updates, requesting future episodes, or getting help with your own Dubsado account, take a look at the links in the description below this video or visit saralede.com. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.